if it's crucial to be a success adoption of your Office 365. Some useful tips how to your end users are using and how your organization will adopt them, and to learn more about Office 365. I'm Amy VB of Office Servers and Services, MCT also, and I advise my clients to proactive adopt new technologies. Here are my contacts, and how you use the best practice adoption is crucial for a successful use of Office 365. All of you, for example, if you are using Office 365, it's difficult to learn all the technologies, and you have to be on time at each shows on news, for example, and when a new feature comes, you have to learn and to deliver to the end users. To be a success, you need to set a vision, identify the business scenario that you have in your organization, that's crucial, and you have to prioritize what will be delivered to your organization. Then, you want to commit what you want to deliver, and you need the end users to learn and give feedback to you to be more precise. You need to move adoption there to space. It always depends on the solution you are now, if it's on-premise email or file server or mobile experience, always depends on the factor. And you need to identify which technology you will use. For example, on email you have more features online than probably your on-premise solution. There will be Exchange Online, for example, to end your file server to go to OneDrive for Business, and easy to share to edit yourself and in collaboration, Office 365 Pro Plus. It's often flexibility that you need. Now you need to define the success criteria. Use smart mnemonic. If you use this, you will have success in the project, because you need to measure, to be timely, you need all these factors. If you don't use, for example, this kind of mnemonic, it's better to understand where the people are at the time, if they are adopting, and for example, if they need more learn paths or whatever. That's very interesting. And to maximize, you need communications, engaging events, and training. If you don't do any of those, the people don't adopt Office 365. For example, when delivered to you a new tool, for example, or a new office, if you don't have any training, you lose many time to see just small features, for example. And if you have just a little training, will push you to adopt and to learn more. Drive awareness. You need to show people who they are and give them feedback. We have to involve the people of the organization to be more inside your project, because if the people are involved, they will give you more feedback and could be better to all. If you don't involve people, they doesn't care to us. And deliver simple target training. Very short videos, for example, some teasers, some, for example, emails or communications, very short. Because if you give them a big manual, many people don't read. You have to be direct message, just a few sentences that it's needed to the people read. It's a presentation that if you give, for example, a manual of 10 pages, maybe 10% of the persons will read all. And you need some steps. For example, when a new feature go out, you can go roll out and you have new features all months, for example. But for your own adoption, you can, for example, put your calendar a launch day for a new feature or a new communication. You have to do cadence. The people must be involved to all features. For example, if you implement Office 365 and you don't tell the people new features that are coming or new features that are available, it's more less to the people to not be so good. And if you do that communications, the people know new features and will use them. Some useful tips and resources to drive adoptions. The world has changed. Now we have a huge problem. Why? Because we have all connections, many data from many sources. And the biggest problem of all, we have infinite data but finite time. You don't have time to read all, correct? You need tools to focus and what you want. You don't read all emails, for example, or all sources, all news. We don't have time today because we have many information to us. And with this, Office 365 give people the modern workplace. If your organization have possibilities to the people work in a different way, anywhere, they will be more productive. Because if you don't let people work where they want, if they are precise, who cares? Don't be at the office each day from 9 to 5, for example, it's not productive. And collaboration. Use Skype for business, experience, security. For example, you can connect Skype to Skype personal. Secure social network business, you can use Teams, you can have bots to help them. It's a channel, you can create channels and edit in real time. OneDrive for business, to have all the data in one place, you can edit your content anywhere in any device. And use Excel or Word or PowerPoint on any device also. Let's do a demo. okay, we have here Teams. Which of you are using Teams now? Okay, very good. In last 2 weeks, Microsoft has released the guest access to your tenant. That's where I'm gonna show you. I have created a team. I have created here a channel, for example, and I can start here a conversation. And let me see if someone here are online. Okay, I am. Eunice Thiago is helping me with a demo, a live demo in a guest access. That's the coolest thing that we can have together, different organizations, to work at the same place. And for example, we can go here to files, I can create a file. You can use, for example, Word directly in the browser. You can use the Word on your desktop, or even, for example, I can edit directly in Teams, for example. I'm gonna edit in Teams just to show you. We have full Word and Thiago is editing, and we can chat too. It's initiating conversation. And it's very easy to work together in a document, no matter where we are. Other things that you can do on Teams, for example, you can do videos or you can do appointments. For example, I can go here to Thiago and chat with him. And then I can, for example, create a meeting directly here, and you can create another channels, for example. You can put here, for example, the meetings. We'll show you all meetings, and you can schedule directly here the meetings, for example. You have to download the app, just a few minutes, because this feature is not directly on browser yet, it's coming soon. Thank you. I can go here to the meetings, go through here, and join. Let's test. Thiago is joining. Okay, you can film the whole people just to show all you are here, and it's very good. Okay, this was a case study 1 year ago, a municipality that has used at that time planner. With planner they have do more production in small projects. Now they are using teams. But before with planner they have increased 20% collaboration just with planner. Because just with groups you can do conversation, but in a small project, small tasks, to keep the people together, they have increased 20% in collaboration. Now in teams, they don't have numbers yet, but with the new function to invite other people will increase a lot. And to learn more about Office 365, go to the roadmap. There will be new features, and go to Tech Community. At Tech Community, you have there a community of Office 365. You have their Teams channel. You have, for example, Ignite. All the presentations will be at Tech Community at the Ignite. Just a summary, how to adopt, how to be more productive, how to use best practice, and how to take the integration advantage. If you use all these, you will be better in your organization and they will use more Office 365. Okay, I'm available if you have questions. Yeah? Yeah. Yes, the calendar, if I understand your question, it's your calendar from your inbox, and you can put there the your agenda of Teams, for example, not was there. Yes. No, that was, I just downloaded the app just because the video. Just because the video. Because now it's not available on the browser yet. When it will be, maybe next year you can see at the roadmap. Okay. Any more? Yeah.
When you're sharing files or sharing information with your team, if you have a certain file that you only want part of your team, is there a way, because in groups you could not permission only part of the team to use it, or part of the group? In teams, are we going to be able to do that where we can only share with a portion, or is it going to be everybody is always going to have access to it?
On the start, It creates a SharePoint site. All people can collaborate directly. After, you can create, for example, a folder and give permissions, and the files, you can change that because it's based on SharePoint. Anyone? Okay, please evaluate this session. The feedback, it's important. And thank you.
Vocês